Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. This is our Goldcrest Valley map, and you know, I've only got about $20,000 right now, and that barely buys a pressure washer, and boy, we need one. So I think I'm going to start this episode by doing what I was going to do before the episode. I was thinking of going through maybe this field and this field and contract these out and get them done, and I don't know, get close to 100,000 in the bank, whatever these are gonna net me, and then kind of start the episode. You know, we're right here at the shop, see if there's anything we need to buy, bring it back, and then head, you know, start working the fields again there. But I think, yeah, I'm gonna work these two, get some money, and then we'll get going. But I'm not going to cut it all out. I'll at least show little snippets of what I was doing so you get a sense of what's going on. But let's start. Let me jump out of here with this field. And we'll get this going, and then I'll snip out the rest. So we've got corn to take down in this one, harvesting. So it says ready to get to work. I need that field over there pulled up quick so I can get it to market. Between you and me, this has not been the best month, financially speaking. I mean, don't worry, I've got the $17,415 set aside for you when you harvest the field. It's just that these other guys are really on my case to pay back a loan. So, he needs this done. And he's asking for help, so let's go for it. So we're going to start this job. What have we got here? The New Holland. My own volume up here a little bit. And DPI switch there. No. 1, 2, 3. Woohoo! There we go. Alright, back him up. What's behind me? Oh, we do have stuff behind. Sneak right into there. Whoa, stop. Oh, took out a post. Yeah. Oh, we're gonna take out another one. Awfully tight quarters here. I think I got it, but I'm not going to get to this. Okay, well, we'll try it like that. See if I can attach at that point. There we go, that'll do it. All right, let's unfold this guy, and then G and unfold this guy. Lots going on here. All the stalks of corn will dive right in between these big old teeth out here, get chopped off, and then the corn will drop into the auger there and get thrown up through there and eventually land in here. It's really a neat thing to watch. So let's get this guy in position, not taking anything out. Alright, so G to get back into here. V does not do anything. V does. There we go. There's the animations there. Oh, look at the in between the big teeth there. Yeah, that's neat. Let's go. Fairly lined up there. Let's see what's happening here. So sucks it down in. The ears of corn are on that auger there. See, am I still aligned? Yep. Get to where I can see the auger. The corn hides it. Right there, pulling the corn, the ears of corn over to the center. Somehow it magically shucks it. I am very impressed with that. Okay, I'm gonna plow through this now. Well, let's look at the cap first. Before I zip away. Oh, fancy. There's the corn being thrown in. It looks like corn, too. Missing it right there. Pull over that way a touch. Touch more. There it is. Okay. So, passenger seat. And all of your controls. Joystick. Computer display up there. Pretty nifty stuff. Very comfortable, too. All right. see how well I can make this turn. 180 here at the end. Okay, out a little. 180. Something like that. Yeah, that works. Remember, it's not the goal to get 100% of the field here. The goal is to get 97% of it done as fast as you possibly can. So if leaving a little bit on one edge, make sure that every one of these little tines here are active and working, then that will get you a little bit better time bonus. Well, we're getting there. Campers a little quieter. There we go. So I think this job was what, 17,000? So I'm guessing now that things have been adjusted that a perfect time might be half of the contract price. So that'd be 8,500 more, and then less for longer times after that. So we should be able to get at least 22,000 out of this job, I'm gonna make the guess. And my green pipe there is almost closed off. So the end of this row might be enough. Otherwise we'll make one more turn at the end and swing back and jump in the pickup and go over to that sugar beet field, and I'll plow through that one too. That one's gonna take a lot more time. Sugar beets. Have just a narrow path in front of the harvester, and you got to chew off the tops and then dig down and get the tuber out of there. Alright, so right in there, and that should pop any second now. So sugar beets, I might just record myself just once in a while, maybe the same point in the middle of each pass. Going one direction, then the next, and then, you know, a little 2 seconds for each one or something. We'll see. This one's just about done. Tiniest little sliver up there left. And there it goes. Alright, what was that? 23, 24. Nice. Okay, that's done. Out of curiosity, we could do a spraying in here. That actually goes pretty fast. You know, I'll do that one as well. So, yeah, probably the first quarter of this video is just a quick little snippets of these three jobs, just to get us some money. Kind of fun to watch the equipment unfold. That wasn't it. Oh, I'm too close. There we go. Okay. What is this thing? The Voltra. Is it actually is that the brand Voltra? Or is it the Voltra model of something? Don't know, but I'm not gonna have room for this thing. So I'm gonna drive this thing over here while it's unfolding. Just how I'm going to attack this field. Probably have to just go in a circle around this thing. Okay. Yeah, something like this. All the way around, then curve myself back in. This one I might just not snip out. I mean, it's going to be over about as fast as I get it started. So I'm thinking that same width out like that. Yeah, that's going to work. So, not how I would do it for myself. So, for myself, I would probably either not use this equipment on this field, or I'd have all these trees cut down and have room to do it. So, with your own fields, and you've kind of bought just the right equipment to run them, rather than whatever this particular farmer had available, then you can custom choose what you want to use, and you know, here and there, whatever works best. Nice if you own both these fields, you just cut across both of them and fertilize both at the same time. But he's about that width to the edge, so if I turn it that same width right about there, it should end kind of the same distance right there. Yeah, I think that works. So I guess if we own this one, I might consider doing something like this to it and then going back in with a smaller one to clean up the corners. Maybe that's the tactic. Not necessarily stuck with using only one piece of equipment for one field. Alright, so how am I going to merge in with where I began? Because that was quite a mess at that first corner. Well, I'm thinking about it though. Here's this cab. They always seem to have a passenger seat right there. So it makes me wonder if it's the same company on some of these. Where are we? Here we are. Alright, that's about the right distance there. So, I'm hoping... Yeah, I'm leaving quite a bit behind. So I might not have enough here. I'm hoping that I can just go back up one corner, catch those two or three triangles, and that'll be enough. But we'll see. Well, it looks like what's left over is less than one width, so that's definitely helpful. I'm getting 9 out of there. Ah, now I can see what I'm doing. Okay. So, when we turn around and come back to the other side, we'll, if it's not enough, we'll head out to that one corner down there and catch those two triangles and really hope it's enough. Whoops, supposed to turn already. Because there's not going to be any room to turn around once I go out that triangle, not that corner. Okay, right there. Ought to swing over and catch as much of that one as possible. Over. What's my Pac-Man look like? Well, it's iffy. Oh, I'm driving around like a drunk farmer here. There we go. I'm looking at other things. Then I look down at my tractor and realize I didn't stop where I thought I did. Okay. From here, I would say we're going to head off toward the right. Head to that triangle over there. That should be the most surface, but let's... Oh, we made it. Good job. All right, so there's 5,000 more. Okay, and if I were to do it again? R? No. I did this once in a game for myself. This plow looks huge, but when it unfolds, it's still... It feels so narrow. It's like that corn header. Actually, even narrower than that, what we did to take the corn out of here. So, 42 minutes. That's just too much time. So, we're going to say no thank you and move on. So, what else can we do to gain us a little bit of funds here? Let's do a 180 here. Whoa, take out a tree. Get over there. Ah, that's better. And actually, I want to be right here. But I'm going to pull over into here. Alright. Alright, so sweet potatoes. It's an interesting machine here. So this guy is going to rip all the tops off of the potatoes. And then right in the back, it's going to be start digging down in and digging them up. And then conveyor them up into this guy. Or it's going to sort them and conveyor them over the top and drop them in. There's a lot of really interesting animations with this machine. They're saying an hour 21. Yeah, so that means what? Maybe 90 minutes, 80 minutes. So I'm going to compress this whole field tremendously in this episode. Actually, there's something else I wish we had done first. Well, it'll be okay. Well, I wanted to get the last field going on our farm, but that'll be fine. I did take the time back to 1-for-1 to do all of this, so there's still plenty of daylight to get that going. Anyway, let's get this one started. All right, he attaches. Looks like, I know it's here, but this one's kind of catches you off guard. That feels like the back end there, but that's actually the back there. Did I really park there? Man, you just never know where you can park in these fields. Okay, we're going to go this way. Let's see if I can catch it at just enough of an angle here to make that work. Didn't happen. Okay. Try it again. Whoa! Okay. Did that do it? I didn't do it either. There it is. So, rather narrow working width. Can I make that work in the air? I cannot. I'm gonna unfold something. Oh, wow. Lots of things happening here. That does that. That's all unfolding. There it is. Everything starts to turn and churn in there. Augers rotating and lots of fun stuff. Okay, let's dive in. Get to where I can show you all the animations. So let's start here. We're chewing up the tops. And then, what are these guys going up and down doing? I'm not sure. This looks like there's blades in here and it's chewing the tops up. At some point, it's digging down underneath. Okay, you got dirt spilling out of here. So it's digging down underneath and bringing up the sweet potatoes. And they're being drawn up into that conveyor right there. They work their way through. I see they get out of field already? Wow. I'm not going to be necessarily super clean on this field. The goal here really is time. So we're just going to do that for a corner this time. So it looks like it gets tossed into these tracks in here where all of the extra drops off and just the sweet potatoes are left in there. Up the conveyor here, spills into there. There's our sweet potatoes. And then the auger up above, where am I at here? Yeah. Keeps working it down the length here as it starts to overfill at the place where it dumps in. Now what is this guy? Oh, that belt goes all the way around the tractor. Interesting. This one here is for pouring it back out, I'm guessing. So it reverses. Okay, neat. So I'm going to start running around in circles and see if we can't get 97% of this thing done as fast as possible. See you in a while. Thank you. just realized, I keep calling these sweet potatoes. I think they are sugar beets. I have to look that up again. It might not be sweet potatoes, I guess. I'm not sure now. I was just thinking to myself that I bet you a beet harvesting is very similar to them. And it dawned on me, are those beets? I'll have to check that when I'm done with this. Okay, so what's the tactic for when this gets too narrow to turn this beast around? I guess I go wide or continue past. I think I can get one more 180 out of this now. Just hold it, where do I land? Actually, alright, next one's the last one. Well, I think that was it. Yeah, that was it. It's a messy job no matter what. Well, I wouldn't hire me to do this. Drive down both of these diagonals just to make sure I don't have to come back out to this end again. Just kind of hit right up the center here, get as much as we possibly can, and do the other on the way back, and hope that there's enough left at the other end of the field to accomplish our goal. Floor it down over here. Like driving a big city bus. Alright, back down this diagonal. And then I guess off to that corner of the other L. Let's see here. 9. Yeah. So this is our center. Get over here and get going again. Can I clean up on the way though? I guess right here. Notice something. The rear auger turned off because it's full back here. It's not rotating anymore. No longer trying to drive more product back there. It's interesting that it would sense that. It's getting skinny here now. I'm going to take a run out this diagonal. Head back over to the right. Thank you. Okay, the home stretch here. Lots of little stuffs left behind all over the field. Hoping this last diagonal here, and that patch out there is enough to finish it. Should be. We're just a sliver left on our Pac-Man. I think we'll be okay. Then we'll head back to the farm, and I want to put in oilseed radishes in that last field. Let's see, I'm going to grow on the back side of this. And that's a crop that you grow to growth stage one and then cultivate it right back in, and it becomes a kind of an organic fertilizer. I think that's a good tactic to use in that last field, just so we can see how that works. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Well, I have to do that out here. Spin this guy around real quick. Whoa, out of control. City bus. It feels like a city bus, the way it's shaking so hard. So, that sliver is so close. We're going to make one more U-turn. The tree right there. Yeah, okay. Speed through it. Back in here. Start harvesting. Oh, went past. There was a lot of momentum in this thing. It'll react much faster, but this should be it. There's no line left on that circle. Oh, come on. Oh, man. Alright, let's pull back into here. And we'll go for this one. Okay, under control. There it is. They do a good job of making it feel like it's heavy. Oh, really? I missed it again? Okay, let's go here then. There we go. All right, so there's another 50, 60, 70,000-ish. 116. All right, now we've got enough to do some work. Need to, how do we bend or dent up the rear quarter here? We whacked it pretty good there. Anyway, let's go home. But I have been recording now for, I don't know, an hour and 20 minutes. No lag at all. I really wonder if it's a combination of a graphics-heavy game and, how do you get out of here? Oh, we're going to jump here. And the pedals of the steering wheel and the recording software. All of it combined. You are going to. Yep, they don't stop in this game. You have to swerve around them. Of course, it is 25 miles an hour in there, and I was doing almost 40, so that might have had something to do with it. All right, find the sculpture and turn in. Get the sower going with the radishes. That's right, I want to check to see what that crop was actually called. So when we get there, I'll do that. And I'll show you something else that I just discovered too when I get there. I have been messing up the help menu, or the help section of the main menu. I'll show you. It actually says a whole lot more than I had given it credit. How fast am I going? Almost 40. There's our turn. Whoops. So where is the sower? Oh, looks like the first stage of growth on our barley has come up. So the sower had just finished that job, right? Put it down here. Yep, there it is. Yeah, we'll leave the pickup right here. Just have to remember where we left it. Alright, so hop out. So that, we did put barley in this one, right? So first stage, second stage of growth. So first stage is actually seeds. So as you put the seeds in, you get the lightest green. Then we're at this stage right here. So that means this one and this one have both started to grow. Yeah, that's right. No, this is, where are we? We're right there. That's the barley. So behind us is the canola. Okay, so that one is on its first stage. This one over here is what I want to put the oilseed radish in. So it is sugar beet. It is sugar beet, not sweet potato. Okay, that's why it looked, it reminded me so much of beets, just not the red kind. This is the sugar beet. So what are the other beets called, the ones that are really red? Don't know. Anyway, this right here I noticed last night when I was playing this for myself, just enjoying it. It's so much more fun when you don't have to, stop at 40 or 50 minutes and try to create episodes, just to sit back and enjoy the game. I've always kind of gotten stuck right in here, thinking that these aren't really showing me that much. I didn't realize that this was available. So we've got all kinds of other categories of how to do things in the game. How to deal with straw and silage, how it all works, buying fields, everything you need to know about the animals, forestry, how all that works. So there is an awful lot to the help menu that I had missed. And let's see, so grain root crops. Okay, so here's our sweet potatoes. Sugar beets. I'm going to mess that up this entire series, I'll bet. So there's the sugar beets, and there's the potatoes. And then your wheat, canola, wheat, barley, canola, and that's corn, yeah. Corn, then sunflower, and then the soybean. So the order here represents the symbols there. And then hay and grass, chaff, straw, silage, TMR, total mixed rations. So you feed this to the cattle. And fertilizers, how you get it. And more specifically, manure and slurries. And then log and wood chips, how you deal with those. Milk and wool, pigs and chickens. There's an awful lot here. And most of it is described with pictures. So rather than a bunch of text. Of course, as I say that, all of these are text. All your placeables. So income from your greenhouses and power generation and bees, I think that is. Let's see, what does it say here? Doesn't say. There we go, bee houses right there. So there's a lot more to the help menu than I had given a credit. So anyway, I want to get, well, let's peek over here at, well, we'll drive over there. The canola, first stage. And we need to get fertilizer and seed into this thing. So this is in the air? Yes. Here we go. So there's the canola first stage of growth. And theoretically, we could take a weeder through here. Yeah. Well, let's get the oilseed radish going. And then maybe next episode we'll take some of our 116,000 and get to work on, we'll research the weeder and see if that's for every crop or just certain ones. Looking at it, it kind of blows me away that it works. It seems like it would tear the tops off all these little crops. So somehow it rips all the weeds up, but doesn't rip up the little seedlings. Not quite sure how that works. I need to go and check that out. Let's back up into here and fill the top of this thing off. And this is a smaller field, so it's very possible that this field, the one we're going to go to, will actually handle one sower full. Will handle it. So here are, that's filling up the seed. And if we back up, I could not get that to fill last time, and I still can't get it to fill. Why is that? That 407 will not go up. There's no chances this stuff, is it? This should be liquid. This shouldn't be it. It shouldn't even raise the doors. It doesn't. So what is with that? Those last two are fertilizer. Okay, let me back up very specifically to them. If I can judge my distances here. All right, and R? Nothing. That is so strange. Back up a little further. I got nothing. There's no toggling. Let me see here. F1. Refill sower. Turn on sower. Lower. That's it. If I hit G, there is no G. Okay. Well, I can't make that fertilizer go in, and I'm not sure why. Anyway, let's do the the horror movie thing and spin my head all the way around. And let's get out here and sow this field with, I'm trying to think what it is here. Y? Yeah, so as we're going, of course I can't steer and hit the Y. Well, seed radish. I think it was the one I just passed. That one. Alright, so let's verify that. Right there. It's the only one with two branches. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4 back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, see radish. Yeah, so the one with the two branches. That one. Okay. So back up a little bit higher. And up he goes. So I need to jump out of here. Alright. So, what was it I was going to do? Weeder. Let's research the weeder. Let's go over here and do it, because he's going to possibly make a big wide turn when he gets back here. So, not that one. Let's go to the shop. Where would that be? Weeders. Oh, that was convenient. So, how does this work? The $34,000 one does what? Weeders pull weeds out between small grown crops, improving the field state. It can only be used in the first growing stage of crops. Okay. It's not showing me a list of crops that it can handle, so I assume that means it can do all. It is 12 meters wide, and it needs 95 horsepower. No additional information there. And no options. So that's something we want to do. What else do we want? We want the weeder. I'm going to want to get into some trees for, if not next episode, the one after that. Boy, he almost whacked us right there. He does go out wide. That's what I was doing last night on my other game, and was having a ball doing it. Grab a chainsaw and grab this guy. That goes in the back of a tractor, and it grinds the stumps down. And then, actually back to that. No, it's baling. Where's baling? Right there. So load this guy in the back of the pickup truck. It can handle it just barely. And chainsaw, drop the logs onto the trailer and the little stubs into the pickup truck and haul it off to the sawmill. And I had a ball doing that. What I'm thinking of, because we're going to need grass for our sheep and probably for the cattle as well. If we take out these trees right here, and then those trees are at that end, we basically have a grass pasture right here to mow and either bale it as rolled grass or what is the term? Tedder? Yeah, tedder it. And back. There we go. Turns grass so it'll dry faster. Basically, it turns it into hay. So we can tedder it for, 10 to 25,000. And then you can get the baler and bale it up. So there's lots that we can do back in this swath right here without having to convert one of our fields into grass. Or without having to run the perimeter or the edge of every one of our fields trying to get enough grass to do any good. So there's that going on. He's going to be a while doing that. Speed is back to 1-to-1. So we've got time to go and pick up some things. But let's go get... let's go get the weeder. That'll be a good idea. And I have no idea what my timing is in this episode. So it's so much of it's been clipped out. So I'm going to say I'm at 30 to 40 minutes already. We'll see what I actually trimmed out, because I don't know at this point. I'm just guessing. So we'll spend another 15 to 20 minutes in here. See how this goes. I probably should get this with the tractor, but I'm going to try hauling it back in with the pickup truck. I'm going to start making more use of the pickup truck. But if I'm going to do that, I got to get back in the cab where I can control the driving a little better. So clear that way and that way. And yeah, I won't. I'll go at 70 miles an hour in here. But I'm not going to stay behind this guy all the way. If he doesn't turn, I will. Okay. It is still hard to regulate the speed for me. It's so much different seeing it than feeling it. Driving your own car, you get a sense of the speed because of how everything feels. So let's... I've never tried virtual reality on a computer. I wonder if you're going to... You know, if your imagination is going to create that sense of movement. Because right here, it's like I'm completely numb. I have no sense of movement in this thing. It's just a smooth trip. Unless I'm looking down there at that 30, I have no idea how fast I'm going. So I'm curious what virtual reality would be like. Of course, that's way out of my budget. But one of these years, when it becomes a little more common, then, gaming computers used to be way out of my budget, too. This one I built myself. So one of these days, 3 or 4 years, maybe we'll get to create a virtual reality setup and see what that's like. All right, so let's park this guy over here and pick out a weeder. Not a windrower. Where'd I lose you? There you are. So, this guy, 12 feet wide. This guy, only 12 meters wide. This one, 9 meters wide, 80 horsepower. So it takes less power and it does less of a width, yet it costs almost 3 times more. So what am I missing here? Same description. None of them are in my garage. 300. What is that symbol? Whatever it is not here. I wonder, I'm looking at these green hoses here. I wonder if that hopper right there holds fertilizer. If you can weed it and fertilize it at the same time. Is that what that is? Yeah, I wish the description was a little bit better. And it does something with grass and oilseed radish. I think that's a symbol you see on the side of a lawnmower that you can cut your hand off. So it's almost like it cuts out the grass and the oilseed radish. I wonder if it then it preps everything and fertilizes it. So it does a whole lot more than we need to do. So I'm not going to repeat those 3 fields again to get enough money to buy the rest of our stuff because we spent it all on this guy. So we're going to go this route right here. So select him, no options, buy, yes, okay. And back. There it is. So can we get it home with this? I'm hoping that there was a ball hitch on here. I'm completely wrong. Okay. So what is there to get that has a ball hitch that we could use? One thing I do want to get soon, though now may not be the time. Well, we do need a baler eventually. What do these guys cost? So this guy's 60,000. That's a lot. This guy. He is a bale collector? He uses a collection of bales. A bale collector. You are a baler turned straw. So that's actually a baler. What is a bale collector? I thought that was like a square baler. Collect square bales? Boy, I wish there was a way to see it. Well, there kind of is a way to see a demonstration. If you happen to find the right field to contract, and there, though I've not noticed any baling contracts, this is a collector that I'm used to. This little arm will pop out and pick up the bales, and it'll stack it in here, and it's really fun to watch the animation. This guy does what? A bale wrapper. So this will wrap it up for grass bales. You know, think of sod, in a sense, and it'll wrap it up and turn it into silage, ferment it, turn it into a bag of fertilizer, basically. Okay, so we're not going to go this route. Is there anything that we do need that has a hitch, a ball hitch right in front, that the truck can haul home? We've got our foraging wagon, or loading wagon. Loading wagon. What's the difference between that and, did I not see a, no, I thought they were foraging wagons, so I guess they're loading wagons. Okay, so, weeder. That guy is a three-point hitch. What do you call the trailers? Tippers? Yeah, we've got this guy. I do want to get a set of them that will attach to each other, and there is a ball hitch on the back, so I can put this guy on the back and get two or three in a row. So eventually we're going to want another one of these. Though it may be nice to get one that has a little more capacity. This guy is 8,000, 85, not much more, and almost the same price. What's the difference? Now, does it say that they will attach to each other? I assume that the puzzle piece means that it will attach to a, I don't know what a, oh, there is an 8041 and the 16. So these guys will all attach to each other, I'm thinking. This will go to the D8. DB8. I don't see that one. So I've got to learn exactly. Oh, there's the DB8 there. And the HKD302. This guy's quite tall. So I don't know that everything can reach over the top of that. So I think for now we're going to be in this range. But it's not money I really want to spend right now. Let me just kind of glance through this. Let's see, where's the beginning? Anything on sale? Nothing on sale. So is there anything right now that we can bring home to justify this trip? The sprayer we're going to need soon, too, but that's a three-point hitch also. And that's another 24, at least 24. That's enough to do one field at a time. So 24, and the baler was 60. Yeah, this money goes by really fast. It really does. Oh, sewing machines, weeders. Is there anything else that we can drive home right now? I have a feeling there's not. Even, let's see, we go into here next. I'm just glancing through. So even this is a three-point hit, so I can't bring that one home now. Now, I think I am done. Some of your bigger harvesters and combines, like we've been using, those headers are so big that you'll actually drop them onto a trailer and then back up and hook it to the back of your harvester and drive it away with the header going parallel to the road. That's how you get those big things through the map. So I am running out of choices here, aren't I? Yeah. Let's do this, though, while we're here. Let's go ahead and place this guy. I want to start using this. And let's get this going as well. So let's start with this one. So select buy. And here's how this works. Let's use a WASD. Yeah. Now, where are we from here? And I can't turn. That was odd. Am I still recording? Yeah. I center clicked and I went out of my game. Okay. So I can't rotate my map, or if I can, I don't know how. So if I were to click and drag, yeah, I can't do anything. I gotta be careful, I accidentally buy it. Don't want to place it. So we're on that side of the river. So we'll just have to do this the hard way. Don't know if I can hold shift or control and go faster. Oh, I can. There we go, that helps. So we are close. We're up there. So W, shift. Okay. Alright, so where do we want this guy to be? I want to be able to pull up to it and change things around. Boy, I wish I can spin my map around. If I hold the, oh, okay, we can get it red. Hold down the right mouse button. No, that doesn't rotate the map either. Okay, I know Q and E rotates the building. So is that something that goes here? Maybe this is our maintenance island here. Yeah, kind of like that. That guy can go there. Yeah, right there. That way he's facing outward toward the house. And the trailer can still pull up behind, and we can put the bring the front loader over to it and unload things. So that guy goes there, and this is going to be 28,000. Boom. And there's no sound when I'm doing this. So what, escape? Escape. All right. So unfortunately, I've got to do this all over again for this guy, don't I? Let's buy that one. And we're back at the store. Okay, hold the shift down and fire off this way. Now I got to figure it out. So our farm is there. So where do we want? I guess in our maintenance island. Okay, so to clean off the equipment. I may want to put some other kind of a building here. Let's go off to this little front corner right there. And I think aimed in that direction would be fine. Yeah, we'll do that. All right, escape, and we're out of here, and we're out. So that's going to have to sit right after we get a tractor. So, just spent all kinds of money. 279 in wages. Is he done? Huh. That seemed awfully quick. Too quick. I wonder if working with the placeables took us out of some kind of a mode for hired hands, and I've got to go get them started again. Back into the cab. There we go. Now I can get a sense of where I'm going. All right, 25 in here, right? So something like that. Actually, I can cruise control that, kind of. Yeah, I could do that. Just see if I can stay tracked here. Let's hold the one down till we get to 25. There we go. So hit the three. And that takes us up to 25. And then once we get past the 25 zone, I can floor it and finish it. So that works. Who else is over here? Nope, just me. We still used almost no gas. That's where we filled up last time. I want to be over here. So where are we going to fill up the fuel on our? Ooh, that's right. I'm on cruise control. I'm going to take that off. Where are we going to fill up the fuel on our tractors? I guess there's fuel here in town, but there is a placeable, I believe, that lets you fuel up there at the farm. So maybe we'll buy that one soon. But it's still going to be quite a while before we need any. First dirt path is ours. So we need a tractor. Which one? And let's drive by that sower and see what happened. Was that just the wages up to that point? Or was that job complete? Or did the job fail? It was a smaller farm, field. So there is that. So it's possible this is real. Where's he at? He's over here. That's odd. Now, we started him at the far end. So he should be completing soon. Yep, that's good. There was nothing else running. So I guess it was just a report of wages at that moment while we were dealing with other wages or something. Okay, so tractor. Let's go park this guy where he belongs. Bring the tractor back and grab that weeder. And then next episode we'll use it. Okay. Which one? That guy, what did I say? 95 horsepower? So this is our... I want to think this was a 125 horsepower. And the cases were 145. Let's see if that's true. P for shop. So garage. All right, this guy is 125. And our case tractors are 145. Good. Just want to keep that in mind. So, fire him up and thread the needle over here. Kind of. Yep. And back to town. And for realism, we will turn on the flashers, if I can reach that button. Here they are, the home button on the keyboard. And then, of course, I'll forget about them. So this one, I have to actually apply the brakes. Helper B has completed their task. Hey, I noticed something in the top right corner. I usually don't see those till I'm editing. But this one does coast, whereas the pickup doesn't. So I've actually got to actively apply brakes on the tractors. So 25, we'll take the back route. How many times I've had a huge load on my own pickup in real life where I'm just dragging that poor thing back home and taking the back route, going nice and slow and taking my corners slow, trying not to put too much strain on those outside wheels or outside tires, worrying that the overloaded springs and all the extra weight might blow the sidewall out. Yep. I have mistreated a few pieces of equipment. But it got the job done. They don't have a stop sign. I see, so that's through traffic going across there. Good there. Oops. That's right, I want to change that. Let's do that real quick. Switch over to... Where's the stop and go braking? There we go. When I hit the brakes... No one, oh, there is someone waiting for me. Okay. Yeah, I'm going. When I hit the brakes, it comes to a stop, and then it starts going backwards. But now, if I hit this switch, it'll stay stopped, and then I've got to let go and hit it again to start going backwards. I'm going to try to start getting used to that. Same with forward. Okay, at least you're not zombies anymore. Yeah. Hello. All right, let's get through here. I gotta get this episode done. And that's the problem. I've gotta take my foot completely off. Just lifting it up a little bit is not enough. Let's see. Oh, and then I gotta let off completely. Yeah, that's too frustrating. I may not keep that setting. But we're in the air. Let's see what this guy looks like. X? Yeah. So he unfolds. All those little wheels. Just whip all the weeds up. tear them up, but somehow doesn't tear up all the seedlings. I don't know how that works. It's a nice wide width, though. We're going to do these ourselves. I'm hiring this job out. That looks like fun. Okay, so lift him back up and let's get going. Holding up my wings there. All the mirrors. All of our attachment in them. Okay, clear that way, clear that way. So here's coasting in this thing compared to the pickup. I wonder if it has to do with weight. I wonder if the same amount of braking is applied to all the vehicles, but the more the weight of the vehicle, the more it overcomes it. That could be a thing. It surprised me how the pickup was only 995 pounds on that scale. So it's possible that this guy is more like 2,000 pounds. I'll have to weigh the tractor someday and see if there's a difference. This is one of the smaller tractors. I wouldn't think that it would be all that heavy, but it might surprise me. And if that's the case, then there's probably nothing they can do with the pickup if it's a constant baseline that's spread out over all the equipment. Just have to get used to it. I like how you can see the brake lights in the rearview mirrors reflecting off the equipment. If I were to tap it now. Okay, so this guy is going out to field 12 first. Wow. Felt everything tip on that one. I took that corner too fast. We do have a lot of weight on us, so if you turn real hard, this guy does a little bit of... Oh, I'm not going fast enough. We'll do a little bit of tipping. Okay, let's line ourselves up. Something like that. And I think we will catch this job next time. But is there any unfinished business right now? Let me think about that. Gone through the help menu, kind of discussed the plan for the next couple of episodes. We want to get the weeding done, and when the oilseed radish will be cultivated, turned back into soil, turned over, and then we'll get the seed into that field. And then we want to take these trees down out here, both sides of that center strip out there, and haul all that off to the sawmill, and then get ourselves a mower. And, in fact, there's a mower that I could have towed home. Huh. And then get a baler and bale that stuff up. Get, I guess, a tedder and turn it into hay. I don't know, there's lots of stuff we can do. So, yeah, lots of excitement coming up in the next dozen episodes or so. So, this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching. And hit the thumbs up down there. I'd really appreciate it. And subscribe if you haven't already. There's a lot more to come. Thanks a lot, folks. Bye-bye.